Hello, this is J100R doing a very brief, small review of the Ubuntu 10.4 or 10.04 Lucid Lynx desktop. This has been a long time coming because there's been a lot that I've tried to cover or a lot that I've wanted to say, but because of the annoying YouTube 10-minute restrictions, I haven't had enough time to say them. So, if I have anything else to add, I will try and, you know, make, you know, multiple part videos on this. Anyway, as I said, this is a review stroke overview of the Ubuntu 10.04 Lucid Lynx desktop. I've switched to Ubuntu, using it as my default now, and I'm settled with it. I'm perfectly happy with it. And I will show you why. I will also show you jumps and differences between like the previous version of Ubuntu, version 9.10, Karmic Koala, and this present version. Now, to start with, the obvious things. The default theme. Now, obviously, I've customized a wallpaper here, but I'll change it back briefly, so you can see the default wallpaper, and so I can actually take you through the new default theme entitled Ambience as best as possible. Now, this is the default wallpaper. These are the default panels. I've not altered them in the slightest. This theme, as I say, if you go into the preferences and appearance lock, is called Ambience. And you see here how the buttons are located on the left side rather than the right side. What does confuse me, however, is in that preview the buttons are still on the right side. I'm not entirely sure what that's about, but either way, I love the whole, you know, the left side buttons take some getting used to, but I do still like it. I do still appreciate it. I'm really starting to enjoy it, you know. And the whole colour scheme, how they've made it darker and got rid of them horrid browns, is way better for me. This theme is for me. It's almost like they made it for me. I really enjoy it. There are some people out there, you know, watching this video might be included, who prefer the human theme or are very annoyed by this theme. If you go online, you know, somewhere like Gnome Look, or you know, there's probably other sites out there you can still download and install the Ubuntu human theme and use that instead if you so wish. But future versions of operating systems, they are all about change. I think this change is for the better. Anyway, I'll keep it on this default wallpaper for now, as I say, but like I say, you can customize it to anything you want, like I did. Now, another feature to go over, which is quite possibly my favorite feature in this. If you look at this icon, this is very similar to Karmic Koala version 9.10. And here you've got chat, which if you click it, it opens up your instant messenger default, which is Empathy. Now you can choose to replace it with Pigeon instant messenger, but it will not fit with the theme of this. It will not, you know, you click chat, it will not bring up Pigeon. As I say, Pigeon will have its own title and icon, so it'll stand out like a sore thumb. I'm perfectly happy with Empathy. It seems to work just as well as Pigeon, if not better. So that's up to you. Set up mail. Well, obviously I've not set up my mail, but that is for integrated evolution support. Now, unfortunately, unlike these two, if you look, they have arrows by them to say, show that them applications are open. I receive desktop notifications from both of these applications. Fully integrated. Evolution Mail, however, if you close the window, you close the program. You have to leave the window open and the annoying little taskbar like switcher or whatever you want to call it, you know, the indicator in the taskbar will remain. You cannot, you know, close it to this notification area. So I think that is a major flaw and I think it should be sorted. As I say, until it is, if it ever is, I will not be using Evolution Mail. I will just be sticking to the web for, you know, checking my mail. If you'll excuse me, I think I got an instant message there. Unfortunately, it looks like some people don't get the message when I'm set to busy. Either way, this is what I wanted to point out next. Broadcast. Now this, I can't open it, but I'll explain it to you. What that does is it opens, if you look, this version of Ubuntu comes with Gwibber social client pre-installed, which you can use to connect to big, like, you know, services like social networking, microblogging services like Facebook and Twitter and others. I have mine connected to Facebook and my Facebook and Twitter accounts. Basically, you have to excuse me, noisy neighbours, and I've lost my trail of thought. Basically, you can receive updates, status updates from friends, and certain updates and requests, whatever, from friends, you know, live desktop updates, you know, using that program from both Facebook and Twitter, and you can send status updates to both of them services. And if that's not good enough, just take a look at this. Now this used to be integrated with the power button here. If you click here, right, you can set yourself a personal avatar next to your username and such. And here you've got your statuses for your chat account, for your messenger, basically. Available, away, busy, visible, offline, blah, blah, blah. As I say, which will change it for your messenger. Here you've got setting up your chat account, setting up your broadcaster accounts in Gwibber, and setting up Ubuntu One, which was also available in Comic Koala. Now this is the interesting part. You see this? This is where you can update your status, you know, send status updates of, to Facebook and Twitter via Gwibber. You don't even have to open a Gwibber window. Just from the desktop, click on your username area here, this, type in there, blah blah blah, and press enter, and it will send it to your Facebook and Twitter. I love that feature. Easy, simple, fully integrated, perfect for me, and I'm sure it would be pretty much the same for many of you out there. Obviously, you've got your power here, you're easy shut down and restart and log off. Basically, they're the only major changes. I mean, the Ubuntu Software Center has had some updates and such. Firefox is still the default web browser. I won't be showing you that, as I have removed Firefox and replaced it with the Chromium web browser, which is now in the repositories, which I'm very happy with. And I will go over that in a future screencast, as to avoid going over on this particular video. I will leave it there for now, so this video doesn't go on for too long. And I will give more information and review certain smaller areas in future videos. And I will accept requests if you want me to cover a specific area of Ubuntu or a software that I may be using or you may want to be using. Please send requests and I will try and accommodate them. Anyway, this is J800R. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.